I really love you.
I love you too.
What are your what's your New Year's resolution?
I don't know. Maybe make an art film.
You want to do it once a day? You know, for a whole year. And each month we can edit it. Good kiss of all eyelids.
Oh, baby.
Eyelid. Let me see the other one. Cheeky. Mwah. Forehead. Mwah. Nosey. Ear.
In public.
Happy New Year.
Oh.
I think I have knots in my hair.
Me too.
It's not fun.
I did not see that. Well, we're talking about elections, right?
To me, kissing.
I'm gonna miss you so much.
She's so beautiful.
Do you ever think?
I do. Yeah.
Bye, honey. Okay, so it's January 4th, and I've just learned that my girlfriend has been sexually harassed. She was taking a bus to go to work, and apparently the bus driver was being really flirty and stopped the bus to go in the back and flirt, and I guess touched them really weirdly. She didn't really talk about it much. She mainly sent it through text to me, but we were on call. But she was at work. She just wanted me on the other line. I just want her to be okay, and I hope it doesn't affect her really bad or take her to a really dark, negative place, and I hope she'll be safe. I am currently walking to my mom's work right now, next to ongoing traffic. I'm not on the street, I'm just walking on the sidewalk. And I went to go get my oil changed, and the place is very close to where my mom works. Used a coupon, saving some money, that's good. Shortly afterwards, I have to go to a dentist's appointment about my molars, and because I think they've been coming in recently and I want them x-rayed. So I want to make sure they're gonna come in okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's what's happening. And oh, and Gardner.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm on a TikTok like street interview right now.
Oh God, yeah, we're here in Hollywood. Yeah,
the amount of Riz faces I'm getting from you guys is just fucking amazing. I'm only gonna be using like a minute of this.
You gotta use more than a minute.
He's squirting it.
Help!
I'm so sorry. It's on camera.
Yeah.
Damn. On camera. That's on camera.
Yeah, it's on camera. What are you gonna do about it?
Jackson Assaults Hope, a new film.
I'm taking you to court.
Yup. Yup. Yeah. I'm like Yoko Ono. Her movie that Elaine wants me to watch.
Grave?
The penis one?
That one.
Oh.
Which one?
The one where she took a video of John Lennon's penis for like 42 minutes.
Oh, that's kind
of
sick.
I haven't seen that one.
I'm surprised.
I like the album where they have their dicks and vagina on the cover.
Oh, yeah.
That one's really good. It's just a bunch of like screaming noises.
It's pretty good.
It's pretty good.
I'm so sorry. I need to stop.
I don't want to be distant with her at all. I just... I'm really not. And I love her so much. I love spending time with her so much, and it's sometimes it's just really fucking hard to like manage all the time and do things, and I've already in making plans, and then she wants to hang out because I like doing a lot of stuff in one day, and you know, she sometimes it's like hard to like manage time to like call her or spend time. I don't know if I'm in the right.
Take my dick like a real man. Cock up my ass like a 4-inch can. Slide in like a cram. EBDB dick cold raisin bran.
Oh my God!
Cold dick in my mouth, no blood flow, just heading south. It's hardly over yet. Get ready for my jumbo jet.
She's capturing
this. Call me
Moby
Dick the way I jum in they jorts. Ride my boy sticks like fucking hamsters G-force. Judy hop on this cock, I'm going Nick Wilde. Just shove in that rock, metamorphic style. I feel like you guys weren't singing along.
Dying. Are you okay to drive?
Yeah, I'm already. I'm losing it over. You went. I feel like you guys are singing along. As it go, it goes, oh, fuck. Oh, my God.
You deserve to not have your self-confidence or your positive feelings about how you look taken away or stripped away. It's something that you fought so hard to, like,
to have. To achieve, basically.
To achieve, yeah. And it's something that you and that's something that you equally need to fight to restore. And prove once again that you are beautiful to not other people, but more importantly yourself.
I don't know, the way that the guy kept calling me beautiful, I just feel like...
Fuck, I'm sorry I keep saying that word. I'm really sorry.
I'm really embarrassed and I feel bad considering she knows I don't like coming, but I don't know why I keep coming. She called me and... She knows I was off, and it's because I came and it fucked with my head. I don't know why I decided to do it. It's to make me feel good. Maybe it's because my sometimes I feel like my hormones don't work the most that they actually should. It just makes me feel like there's someone in my head that I don't want there. I'm sorry, Jane.
It's good. I hope she gets that cleared out because she needs a laptop for work, and also her old one's just been falling apart. Barely fucking charges. Hopefully later today, I could show Hope and Jackson the new film. But Hope hasn't been feeling good the past few days. I think she's been sick and dealing with some family stuff. So that remains to be seen. I know Jackson said he's down if Hope's down, but I'm not sure if Hope would be down. And I also like the show Layla, my friend Layla, the film at the same time. Who knows? My confidence is pretty low. It's gonna happen today, but whatever. And this is Layla.
This is sweet.
We're at the Vim Vendor screen.
I thought Vim Vendors was dead, so when you invited me, I was really
Wait,
sad.
Really? You thought he was dead?
Yeah, he's really old, isn't he?
He's pretty old.
Yeah.
No, he's not dead. Yeah, he's at the screening.
Yeah.
So we're gonna see him.
Yeah, good thing he's alive. Yeah.
Well, I lived in America for 7-8 years, starting to dream in English. Don't know. In that time, sort of realized I was not an American director and I was never going to make an American movie. I didn't have it in me. And then I was happy that with Paris, Texas, I would finally pursue my dream of making a film, at least in America, not an American film. And it was time to go.
Very different than a feature film where everything is pre-scripted, it's planned out. And in documentary, there is no story to go on, right? At least not in the beginning. You have to wait for that story to unfold. And when it will unfold, how it will unfold. Often, in order to get there's a lot of repetition that you have to go through. Some of these characters, a lot of what we're shooting and seeing is the same thing repeated over and over and over. And then suddenly, there's a change, there's a shift. And that's where sometimes the tension and the story start to come out.
正因为这种电影的这种未知，就是我们不知道这个人物和故事会以什么样的方向发展，这是我选择纪录片的一个最重要的原因，因为我觉得这是电影里边最重要的因素。
And it's precisely this element of the unknown which is what draws me to documentary filmmaking, because I don't know where the story is going to go. I don't know where the characters are going to go. And that's the reason I love documentary.
For the coin op one.
And what grandma's
I sold. If they have to maintenance that might be it.
$8,000 worth of autographs.
I saw
over 3 days.
I
made my income for
really
3 months.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
And they had a room open.
Yeah, the fans have been awesome, and my character's barely been in the show yet.
Really?
Yeah.
Only barely?
No, she's been in one episode so far. She made her first appearance in season one episode.
So if we get desperate, he'd be a great...
on screen for about 30 seconds.
If we get really desperate for Sound Mixer, he'd be a great person to get.
But I've received
thousands
of pieces of fan art. cosplayers. Who I met like, when I have said, people cosplay my character.
You're fucking.
This is me surrounded by surrounded by cosplayers of my characters.
This place is so cool, and I'm like, I'm stuck in these, but like right now, I'm like, I have
no you can see they're all in the audience there.
They have the drum.
All right, I gotta go to work. I love you, sweetie.
Hey, no, I love you.
I love you. You. I love you.
You.
Bye.
You. No, don't go.
No,
don't
you.
Go. Don't go. Don't go.
I know go. I shouldn't, but don't I need go. I need to. I need no, to make no, money, no, baby.
No. Oh, and then you can buy plane tickets to see me, yeah?
Exactly, yes.
Come here. Hey. I don't want you to go to work. Not now, not ever. Just stay here and talk to me all day.
As much as I'd like that, I need to. My boss would be very angry with me.
Oh,
all right,
you should
I love
tell
you.
Your boss. You should ask your boss about like taking off mid February.
That's a good idea. All right, I love you. Bye, baby.
I also had a dream revolving around Jackson and Hope. I don't know why, but it felt oddly realistic. It felt oddly like real life. Like, it felt like something that's gonna happen in the near future. Like, we were just sitting outside of either a place that looked like this or like Disneyland. Because it looked a little bit theme park-ish, but I'm not entirely sure if it was that. But we were just sitting at a table and we were talking about like Fat Girl, the Catherine Briot movie. And we were talking about like rape and like ethics of the film and whatnot. How we were all affected by it. And they haven't seen that film either. They haven't seen that film, but I have. So I don't know. Maybe we'll watch that film this year. Who knows? Yeah, who knows? Been having a lot of dreams about people I know recently.
Hi, Mom. Happy birthday.
Hell yeah.
It's just, I can't really do it while I'm walking. And then walking back.
Sorry. You're going to watch that back and you're just going to be like,
oh. He knew! How did he know?
He knew!
He predicted it would be my birthday.
He said hi to me.
I told someone they were beautiful yesterday, and before they could say anything, I said thank you to myself. That was so strange.
Wait, you said thank you to yourself after
yeah,
you
told... Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, oh my god, I'm so sorry to bother you, but you're so beautiful. And then I went, I almost thanked myself. It was so awkward. And I just walked away. Like, I started stumbling on my words, just walked away.
I thought you meant just, like, literally stumbling.
Yeah. Like... Oh, no. Like, drunk or something.
Couldn't remember right foot, left foot.
That's like the second time this has happened with my fucking doctor. The second fucking time. And this is a very, like, this is like, I want to, like, this is an appointment where I'm discussing switching to pill for my estrogen instead of injecting every week. And I haven't injected today, so I'm like, oh shit, I don't want my hormones to be out of whack, and my fucking estrogen expired. And I was hoping to discuss that, and possibly switching the pill, which would be a lot easier for me, and possibly cheaper. And now I can't! They never fucking joined the appointment! I don't know if they're fucking transphobic or whatnot, but it pisses me off. It makes me fucking furious.
I guess my future sister-in-law. She's pregnant, and she's gonna have a kid. And I'm gonna be an aunt. I'm already an aunt to. I guess I'm technically already an aunt to her little adopted ones, and I guess Lily, who's kind of in my same age, but. I'm gonna be an aunt, oh my god, oh my god, I'm already an aunt, but, oh my god, it's crazy. And, oh my god, I'm so happy, and Jane's gonna be an aunt too, and we're gonna be like the cool gay aunts, and I'm so excited for that. Oh my god, I'm so happy I'm with her. I'm so happy. Woo, baby.
You guys want to go first?
Who wants to go first?
I'll go first if no one wants to.
I'll go first. I changed my mind. I want to go first.
You going first? Oh, yeah, the zoom is the Z.
That's beautiful smoke.
Every time I'm off my medication for an extended period of time, I always feel bad. I feel bad for myself, and I feel bad for, you know, the people who are around me. You know, I had fun last night with Cassian and Miles, but I feel like, I don't know, but like, so with my girlfriend and how I view other people. Because when I'm off estrogen or my Spiro, I feel like there's just this compulsive need to fuck and to conquer and to dominate. And I feel like a worse person every time I'm off it. I feel really bad because I see things as competition. I look at things with hate.
I was looking into a bottom surgery that doesn't let you have specific genitals. Maybe I just want to get castrated. I just want my sex drive to be completely gone because I don't really like it. And I just wanted to feel normal with everything. And I was rewatching Hearts of Near 13 Moons by Fassbender, and I saw myself a lot in Elvira and what they were struggling with. Every time you point a camera at me, I'm like, what am I gonna do?
absolutely nothing. I don't know how.
Good thing, man.
Like, truly, what do you expect from me? Direct me.
No.
Okay.
Just be yourself.
Where's your car? Also, are you giving me a ride or am I taking the metro?
Oh, I'm giving you a ride.
Okay, cool.
Nice.
Let's do it. Let's go in the 7-Eleven and get some friggin' brewskis. I mean, not you. Not for a few months.
Oh, shit, you're right. By the way, do you know how I can get a fake?
Get a fake what?
ID.
I don't even know the meaning of the word.
ID?
Why would I ever need a fake ID?
You and...
Oh, yeah.
I actually do have to get a new one. Oh, you're down there.
What do you need to get?
A new driver's license.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, mine expires in 2 weeks. Because I'm turning 25. So. Fuck it, let's walk.
Let's walk.
It's only like an hour and a half to my place.
Really?
Yeah.
If I were to live my life without you in it, in some way, it seems like it would be unlivable, because you've given me so much, and I feel like we're almost this, we feel like the same person, and I love you so much. You complete me, and I hope I complete you. You are the love of my life. Happy birthday, baby. I love you so much, and I cannot wait to spend as many years as I can possibly spend with you. I love you so much, and you mean the world to me.
The chair is standing. The belt is broke, my neck is bright red. I sob into my hands and my heart's still a mess. I guess the ground and my feet meet again. The first step's a joke, but the second it's all too real. The first step's a joke, and the second's all too real. The first step's a joke, but the second tells me if you wanna die. And no, I don't really wanna die.
I don't know. I don't see myself having a vagina. I kind of see myself like having nothing down there. I feel like that's the optimal way I would want myself. Is to be like, have breasts. I don't want to.
Bigger breasts. They're tiny.
See? How big? Do you think you. You have like really decent. You have pretty decent. Well, how big do you want your breasts?
I feel like they've been shrinking a little bit. So, I mean, I'm not wearing a bra right now, but like, I feel like they've been shrinking.
Oh my god. You just did. Hold on. Do that again. No, you did it with both hands, and I'm like...
I like this.
Oh, my God. Oh, you're so fucking beautiful. I can't wait to eat you.
I thought you were asexual.
Oh, baby, I just am asexual with my dick.